wanted to do it since like 8th grade, I think. And I just always wanted to learn about, especially the American, like, culture, mm-hmm. and how it would be to, like, live in a place that's completely different than, like, what I grew up with, I guess.
Yeah.
And also, like, now that I'm here, what I appreciate the most is, like, how much I've learned about myself. And it sounds really cliche.
But it's so
but
true.
It's so true. Like, yeah. I've learned so much. Like, all the people that I talk to that has been exchange students, they always say that you grow mentally, like, 2 years. So when you get back, you're, like, 2 years older than
I wanted to, like, learn better English and, like, yeah. learn your language better.
How it is to live with another family with another culture than you for like that long, mm-hmm. and obviously it's not as easy as you think. But
no, yeah. I was not prepared. Like everyone says, like you can't prepare for it to be like fun all the time. You gotta prepare for like hard times. And I was like, yeah, of course I'm prepared for that. And then I came here and the hard times came, and I was like.
I like always wanted to be an exchange student. I don't even remember when I was so young, like it was since like 7th grade or something. Like as soon as I like knew about the US or like that there was like a world out there, I wanted to go there. Because I remember seeing all these pictures of like people on exchange and off to like foreign countries, and just it sounded so great with like learning new languages and experiences. And also I feel like since I have the opportunity to go, like I might as well.
Yeah, you should take it.
Yeah, because when like later on in life, like when do you have that opportunity again where you can just go abroad for a year and just do something entirely different and
with no responsibilities?
Yeah, because like, I'm still like 17 or I just turned 18, but yeah, like I'm still so young, so I don't have to worry about like working or like I don't have to pay for like the place that I live, like myself, like my parents are still responsible for me, so it's very easy, I think. And also I have so many friends who went on exchange, and I just know that if I stayed at home and like heard about, like if I, and they were like telling me all these stories and like how they were doing, and I would just be so jealous. So I knew I would regret it if I stayed at home, and I don't think a lot of people regret going on an exchange, because you like no matter how it goes, like you always learn something, and you learn about yourself and a new country, sure. and languages and just people. Yeah.
For me, it was when I was really young too. I remember my cousin, she went on an exchange program to England, and we were really close, and when she went, I just missed her so much. But she was like, I'm having such a good time, I'm learning a lot of stuff. And when she came back, she was this different person. She went when she was 16, she was really young, but she came back a different person. Like she had like different, she went to England, so she loved to drink tea and she hated before, and she just had different ways of doing things. I still hate tea.
Yeah.
And she was really like more independent, like we said it before, you get really independent in the exchange program, and she wasn't like that at all before. And I was like, oh my god, that is so nice. And I was really like, I was 7 or something, but in my head that was amazing. It was like, at first when I like started being like a moody teenager, it was like, oh, I'm gonna get away from my parents, this is gonna be awesome. But then after, it was just like about myself, because I had this point when I wanted a different perspective on everything. I thought that would help me, like, well, where I want to go to college, what I'm gonna do, and things like that. And I thought going away and just being with myself would give me a different perspective on that. And yeah, that's like one of the main reasons why I wanted to do it.
Yeah, and just traveling, like seeing as much as possible, that's what I want to do.
behind them sheets. Leave me alone.
It wasn't that hard because I went to England for 8 months before I came here, so but it was still hard because it was like a different country with people that I didn't know again. But I kind of expected when it came, but I think I missed home a lot more than when I went to England, because I had just when I went back home, I stayed there for 3 months and then I came here, so I didn't have a lot of time to like stay with my family and my friends. So when I got here, I just realized that, oh my god, I'm gonna be here for a whole year. I can't go back home now, and I was just there for 3 months, and that really hit me when I got here.
I remember I went to soccer. I started soccer like right away, and that was a lot of fun. So I immediately like met a lot of people, and I remember I was so tired all the time because you get really tired just like in the beginning when you're like translating inside your head all the time, and everything that you say you have to like think about because it's in English and it's not your first language. And so, and just like all the time, you had to be like happy and you had to be forthcoming and be like, oh my god, I'm so excited to be here. And like, oh, what's your name? And my name is this. And this is me.
That is so true.
And yeah,
that is,
it was
that's actually tiring. Yeah.
Like, I remember going to sleep like so early, and I would just, yeah, so that was new.
That is very true. Yeah. Like people, we don't actually talk a lot about that. Like when you're meeting all these new people and you're talking a different language, how tiring it is, because you want to make friends and you want people to like you. So you try to be like polite and cheerful, like, oh, hi, my name is this.
Funny
and I'm,
and
yeah.
And
but
like,
it's, yeah, it's like, it's hard and it's like tiring because you never know who you're gonna meet, if someone's like gonna like you or they're gonna be like, oh.
And it was a lot harder.
So you try, yeah,
than
you
I expected harder. Because like they say that Americans are like, oh my god, like you're a foreigner, like where are you from, and like ask you all these questions, but it's not really true because like they ask you like, oh, you have an accent, like where are you from, and I'm like, oh, I'm from Norway, and they're like, oh, because I don't really know where it is, and they don't know anything about it, and then it's just like, I don't know, they just move on. And it's hard, like it's a lot harder than than people say that it is, but yeah, we got through it. Yay, still here.
What makes like trouble, and I'm not going to change host families and stuff, but I just realized that sometimes it just doesn't work out. Sometimes like
And it doesn't have to be anyone's fault.
Yeah, it's not anyone's fault. And like, they were great people, they were nice people and everything. The ones I am at now are pretty great. And I just like had to realize that it's not my fault, it's not their fault. It's just like, it didn't work out and it's fine. So, Henny, what was your first impression by an American high school?
Oh God, I remember the first day. We sat for like 6 hours in this office and I didn't like really know you guys. Like Mariah wasn't even here, I think. Yeah. And me and Selma, I'd met Selma some days before at this
welcome barbecue
thing at Carolyn's house. And so I like kind of knew who she was, but I didn't know anyone else except like the people that I live with, Giga and Tom. So it was very intimidating, I feel like. But I mean, it was okay. We just sat there, we got our schedules. Was the first week we didn't really do much. It was just like getting into the hang of things.
Yeah. I remember like when I walked in my first class, I didn't like get how the system with like the floors and everything worked. So I used like so long time to like find
me
my
too.
Room.
And I always have the paper in my hand.
Yeah, like where am I going?
But it was great. I mean, American school is very different from Norwegian school.
In Norway, we like the breaks in between classes is at least like 15 to 30 minutes.
Yeah.
And here it's 5. When I first got here, I like didn't go to the bathroom or anything in between classes because I just had to run to my next. I was so scared. So yeah, I just had to like think a lot in my classes because the teacher was like talking so fast sometimes, and I just like I couldn't keep up, and I was like, what? Yeah. And then I was like, probably, and like suddenly he said that we had to do that and that for homework, and I didn't like get it, and that was just confusing.
I guess like for me the problem wasn't understanding; it was like being able to express what
yes.
I was thinking.
Yeah. That too.
Because you can get away with like kind of saying what you mean,
yeah.
but not exactly, and it's so frustrating.
My whole way,
it's very different.
It's different, and like the teachers are more strict about it.
Yeah, and then we would get like, okay, you gotta do this paper before Thursday, and like that's what you do for homework.
Yeah.
Well, here it's like you gotta do
that and those 10 things there and like those 30 things and it's crazy.
Yeah.
And that was a big adjustment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And also like the tests.
The test, yeah.
I hate it. I didn't get that
it was
so
like
much.
Two parts. It's like formative and summative. Someone should have told us about that.
I still don't know the difference.
So now me and Selma are in Boston and we just rent.
It's not working.
First time I saw you, I knew right away. Made up my mind you would be mine someday. You know I need you, so don't turn away. 'Cause at the end of the day, I'll be alright. Change your mind, I'll be okay. 'Cause you'll come around eventually. Hey, hey, hey. When I love someone, I'm loving all the way. okay. Be okay. 'Cause you'll come around eventually. Hey, hey, hey. When I love someone, I'm loving all the way. Hey, hey, hey. You know I'm the one to take you all the way.
Yeah, that looks so good on you.
Yeah, no, yeah, and volleyball. I did volleyball, and it was like really nice. I didn't expect it to be like that because back home, it's not, we don't take sports that seriously. So like we had practice every day, even on Sundays, and everyone really like tried their hardest, and the games were super serious. And back in Brazil, it's like we practice twice a week, and all our games are like, yeah, it's okay. It's not like we're gonna classify for something really big or stuff like that. And here, everyone's just like, yeah, we're gonna do this, and everyone's practicing, and the teams are like really, like they're really good. I wasn't expecting to be that good, but they are. And I just felt like sports here is such a big thing. Everyone does some kind of sport, and that's something that all like exchange students should try to do.
Yeah,
because definitely. Yeah, it's like big here. It's like a really good way to make friends
and meet people. Just like get out of the house in the beginning, like you have to go to practice, you have to show up, and you have to talk to people and communicate, and you get that whole like team spirit and school spirit right away, which is one of the best things about like high school in the US, I think, is the school teams and like school spirit and
Panthers.
Yeah. No, but in Norway, like everything's separate, so the school doesn't have anything to do with the sport. So you play, like I'll have practices from like 7 to 9 in the evening, and it doesn't have anything to do with the school. So I like that, and you also get to like see the people that you actually go to school with every day and go to classes with. So that's nice. Like it's a good way to get to know people. And I played soccer, which was fun. It was really hot in the beginning, and then suddenly it got really cold because it was outside. But it was kind of disappointing too, because I wanted to try something new, and I have played soccer before, but it was okay. And I played for JV because they said that varsity was full. And that was okay too, because it wasn't that serious. Like it was just more relaxed, and I love their coach, and everyone was just like happy and just trying to have a good time. Yay!
So this is our school, Beverly High School.
Standing in a crowded room and I can't see your face. Put your arms around me, tell me everything's okay. In my mind, I'm running around a cold and empty space. Just put your arms around me, tell me everything's okay. Break my bones, but you won't see me fall. Oh, the rising tide.
think having exchange students have definitely benefited our students at Beverly High School. I think it's also benefited our staff and our community by having students from other countries who bring in, they bring in so many different things in terms of just bringing in their own culture, but also they bring a lot of life to our school. The students that we've had have been awesome. They've gotten involved with activities and they've been a positive influence on our school. So I think that everybody benefits by having exchange students at our school. We've been doing this program for 3 years. This is the third year we've been doing the program, and we look forward to many more years. It started with the conversation was that looking for ways that we could offer what we have available in terms of our programming and stuff to other students around the country, but also look for ways where we can also bring in some culture to our school as well. Well, we've had exchanges with, for example, the German class, where students will come over for a couple of weeks. Mm-hmm. In terms of our program that you belong with, we've gone with the full year student because we feel it's important that a student has the full year to really acclimate to our school community and also with the classwork that's required, because many from the program have come over as seniors looking to get a high school diploma. So we've gone more in that direction, and I think that's worked out well for us. But like I said, in German classes, I know they've done that exchange short term, and I've known that our students have gone abroad for a week or two. For example, there was a Spain trip just recently. Not a true exchange like you're going through, but there are some other options in that regard. Yeah. Students that come with us that may struggle with English, we do have ELL classes and programs through Mr. Soames that some students have taken advantage of, and that's been a big help if struggling. If it's just a small piece where we can help a student in the short run, teachers can help to some degree as well as host families. But more importantly, if there's a real struggle, Mr. Soames and the ELL program has helped us. Wow, I wish I did take advantage of being an exchange student. I think I would probably go somewhere warm. That's probably where I would go. I think maybe possibly the French Riviera, maybe somewhere in Spain would be fun to go. Although I've heard Brazil is beautiful as well as many other countries. So I think I'd probably more go with the warmer weather, although Italy would be fascinating to try as well. The advice I would give exchange students coming to Beverly High School would be to get involved and get involved in activities, whether it be sports, whether it be music, whether it be drama, whether it be our clubs. Get involved because you meet more people, you get a chance to fit right in earlier. And I think the students that have been involved with clubs and activities have benefited greatly. I got a chance to meet a cross-section of students that if they weren't involved wouldn't happen. So I think the biggest piece of advice is to get involved and also take advantage of Boston. Boston's a great city. Beverly is a great city too, but get a chance to see the surrounding area to gain that, because many of our exchange students who are seniors are looking to go on to college, and there are many colleges in this area for them to take a look at. But I would say the number one piece of advice is to get involved. Why are fewer students or fewer American students taking advantage of exchange opportunities? I think possibly that might be more culturally based, in the sense that, I think some cultures have it ingrained to get out and travel more and to experience these type of opportunities. I think that just hasn't been as part of our culture necessarily, although we do have some students, in not only in Beverly, but across the country, that do participate in exchange programs, probably not as much, and it's probably just more of a cultural piece than anything else. But I think it's a great opportunity. I do know that some students will often in college, this is more happening, will take a semester and they will study abroad. That's happening more and more, where they'll go to another country and be involved with an internship in their college connected to their college. So I think that's more of the trend than through the high school exchange program.
For me, what I'm gonna take for life is just appreciating more like my family and my country. I always thought I wasn't gonna live in Brazil for my whole life. I was always wanting to get out of there. But now that I've been away for such a long time, I just wanna go back, because I'm so used to, no, it's not like that. It's because I'm so used to the way that we do things. Like, I don't have a filter. I say a lot of things that people here are not used to. They think it's like, oh my God, she can't say that to like someone she just met. And in Brazil, we're just like, yeah, we say that. We don't have a filter, because we're like, we're hot-blooded people, you know? We do that kind of stuff. And I wasn't used to people that weren't like that. And they, not that they judge you, but they do kind of think it's weird. And it just made me appreciate like the little things about my country and like my friends and my family. So I'm just gonna, like, for me, what I'm gonna take is not taking anything for granted, because you don't know when you're gonna have it or when it's gonna be there for you. And for me, it was like, I never wanna go back there. I hate that place. But now it's just like, for me, it's home again, and it wasn't for a really long time.
Yeah, and what I think I've learned is that like, you're responsible for your own happiness. Like, no one else can do that for you. Like, here you don't have, like, you have no system, like no friends or family that you always had, that, like, so no matter what happened at home, like, I was always fine because I had them and they would, like, take care of me and help me. And but here you're all by yourself and you realize, okay, like, if I want to have a good year, then it's all on my shoulders, like, no one else. And that's a big responsibility, and it's something that I really, like, learned a lot from, I think. Just, like, trying to be more out there and open-minded, and...
Okay, so what do you think that you're gonna take away from this?
I've obviously learned a lot, and I've grown a lot as a person, I think. I've learn to be more independent.
Definitely.
And like, don't always rely on my mom and my family.
Yeah.
And now I know for sure that I could actually, like, survive alone in this world.
It's true.
But yeah,
I agree. I feel like I lived in Molde in Norway for 17 years, and everything that I knew was everything was very safe to me. Like I always had my parents to rely on, and I always, like, were in a safe environment. I, like, had a place that I lived in for 17 years. Like, nothing was, like, challenging me. That's how I felt. I felt extremely safe, and that's very comfortable. But you don't learn as much, because this year I've been, obviously, I've been safe, like, I haven't been unsafe, but when all those things are taken away from you, everything that makes you feel safe, you're the only thing that you're left with is yourself. And then that's exactly when you, like, start to understand what you can do, like, by yourself. And I feel like I've grown so much, and I can't even explain it.
Yeah.
But it's great. Like, when I tell my friends, like, I feel like I'm a totally different person, and they're like, how? Like,
yeah,
what are you talking about?
It.
No.
No, it's just like, you feel like you're grown in yourself,
mm-hmm.
and it's hard to explain to others that feeling.
Yeah.
And, like, being an exchange student, it's like, it's all about, like, stepping out of your comfort zone. You're always, like, experiencing new things. You're mostly, like, by yourself. You have to, like, make your own decisions, like, solve conflicts in another way. You need to, like, come up with your own thing.
Yeah.
And that's, like, the hard part.
Yeah,
that you don't think about before you're going.
Yeah, and I think it's good to have some distance from what you've been so, what have been so known to you.
Yeah.
Like, I talk to my parents once a week, the people that I, like, saw, like, 23 hours out of the day before. And it's just crazy, and you really appreciate what you got much more.
Yeah, you do.
Like, even though I love it here, like, I appreciate home so much more now in a totally different way.
Yeah.
Are you farting?
What?
Your bed is moving.
Just rude.
I got this feeling. Oh, wait. I remember when I first came here, I was like, oh my god.
Me too. I've learned so much, it would be so hard to, like, tell you all the things that I've learned.
And have you started?
Yeah.
Yeah, and homework.
Homework. English struggle.
English.
All my friends at home also went on exchange.
You guys can quack. So I'll go type a speech. You guys go quack. You guys want to try that out?